We're back at Northfield High School. That's going to wrap up the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance pregame show here on WROI. Time now for football here at Northfield. The Rochester Zebras have won the toss. They have elected to defer and will kick to the Northfield Norse. And back deep is Jared Viger and also Jared Short and Shane Viger for the Norse. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Week four underway. Wilson Lee approaches the ball and puts a right foot in it. And it's an end-over-end short kick. It's going to be fielded about the 31 by Bickle. Bickle tries to pop it to the sideline, now cuts it back inside, grabbed by the shirt tail, and drags three or four Zebras up to about the 38, 39-yard line. So Northfield here will start in pretty good field position to start the football game.
Well, you don't have to wait long to see what kind of runner Bickle is. Would we say he's not very tall? 5'7", 195-pound senior, yep. And this kid is thick below the waist. Yeah. You're just going to take an effort to bring those legs down to the ground.
He just showed it took three or four of them to even make him go to the ground. So
Northfield will start on their own 39, ball on the far hash, which is the Rochester sideline, going to our right. Wide to the near side is Kendall. Wide to the left side is Brown. Wing T formation for Northfield as Frieden.ci. Frieden, keeper, going around the left side. Across the 40 and falls ahead to about the 44-yard line. So he's going to get about 5 yards on the carry, maybe four. It'll be second down and about six after a 4-yard pickup for the quarterback, Carter Frieden. Jared Short was in motion that time for Northfield. And they huddle up, but quickly on the football with 11:25 to play in the first quarter, no score. Kendall wide to the near side. Brown split left. Under center is Frieden. Sets a line of scrimmage, his fullback is Bickle. We'll watch out and see how that develops. Bickle gets the carry, going right, lowers his head, crosses the 45, maybe to the 46, a couple of the yards there, and that'll bring up third down at about three for the Northfield Norse. Boy, one thing about it, that quarterback is right on, the fullback Bickle is right on the backside of Frieden, so it's almost like snap and give about that quick, and Frieden is, make that Bickle is pretty low to the ground anyway, so he gets under the tacklers pretty easily. Third down and three for Northfield. Frieden under center quickly from his own 46. The fullback takes it off the left side. That's Bickle. He is close to the sticks, and I think they're going to give him the 49-yard line. They're going to stop the clock and look across the way, but I think that's going to be enough for a Northfield first down.
Yeah, Bickle's only lining up about four yards off the line of scrimmage for a tailback, fullback. And
so it'll be first down for Northfield as the ball now at their own 49-yard line, still on the far hash, going to our right. Frieden brings the club to the line of scrimmage. First and 10 for their own 49, sets the group. On the option, gives it to Bickle. Bickle off the left side, goes into Rochester territory, and gets to about the 48-yard line. So giving three, it'll be second and seven.
Frieden does a nice job of keeping that ball secure and hidden. It's hard to tell if he's keeping it himself or giving the ball to Bickle.
Give him two, it'll be second and eight, I beg your pardon. Ball at the Rochester 49. Clock rolls here at Northfield, the fourth game of the regular season. Northfield a perfect 3-0, Rochester 2-1. And Rochester now defensively in their own territory. On second and eight, Frieden under center. Here comes the pressure, flips it out to the near side, ball loose, picked up.
And Bennett on the tackle for the Zebras, almost right there to pick the ball up off the ground. The pitch outside was dropped by
Short.
Viger, was it?
No, Jared Short.
Okay.
But he did get a couple of yards. He had the presence of mind to reach down and on one bounce picked it up and kept his momentum going towards the end zone. He got a couple of yards. It'll bring up third down and six for Northfield at the Rochester 47-yard line. Ball now in the near hash.
Rochester blitzing both linebackers that time, was able to get them in the backfield and force Frieden to pitch it really, really quickly.
Kendall wide to the near side, short side of the field. Frieden under center on third and six. Weiger goes in motion to the left. And Frieden fakes the pitch, and he is hit and dropped for a sack.
Connor McLaughlin was the first one in there on that.
Wes Beck also there for Rochester, and Wilson Lee as well. Loses 2 yards. It'll bring up fourth down and 8. I think that play looked like maybe it was going to be a pitch, but because Rochester grabbed the sleeve of Frieden as he took the snap from center, I think he did the wise thing and just kept it.
Threw off their timing. I also think that he saw Jordan Schaefer there at the end position in front of him and knew he didn't have any play. He tried to turn it upfield and make something.
Northfield will line up in punt formation. Back deep to kick is Jackson Beery, and Jay Heckathorn will slide inside his 20 to receive the kick. Snap is back. The rugby kick, and he's going to keep it. Beery's going to keep it. Look to throw. There's a flag on the play, and Rochester drives him out of bounds at the midfield marker.
And we could have a holding against
Frieden,
Northfield.
I would guess that's right.
He's a little Josh Beck, quite a hand to hang on to. And
so if that is against Northfield, Rochester will probably decline this, I'm guessing, because they'll get it at midfield as the punter, Beery, lost a couple of yards on the rugby-style punt is what it looked like it was setting up to be as he rolled to the Northfield sideline to our right and looked to kick it, then he looked to run it, then he looked to pass it, and then he was hit and dropped for a couple of yards lost. So Rochester will get it on downs after the penalty was against Northfield. So it'll be first and 10 for the Zebras at the midfield marker at the 50-yard line going to our left now.
Are they known for that rugby punt? It didn't look like a punt to me. I just thought he was trying to run the whole time.
Yeah. First and 10 for Rochester at the 50. Bennett and Heckathorn wide to the right side. Hadeshell gets the pitch going right. He's got a blocker, cuts it back inside, gets it to the Northfield 45 and falls inside the 45 to about the 43. So a nice 7-yard run there by Jacob Hadeshell to set up second down and 3 for the Zebras.
Harper on the block for the Zebras out front for Hadeshell.
Under 8 minutes to play, first quarter here at Northfield, no score. Rochester with their first time tonight with a football. They'll break the huddle. Ball on the far sideline. Heckathorn and Benicom split to the near side. Kistler is tight left. Split backs now for John Hunting. On second and 3 for Northfield at the Northfield 40, I'm sorry, for Rochester to Northfield 43. Westbeck gets a carry going left. Westbeck ahead of steam is cut down to the 36-yard line.
Good job by Beck there. I mean, as soon as Hunting gave him the ball, his head was down and he was at full steam just going.
Give him 7 yards. It'll be first and 10 for the Zebras at the Northfield 36.
That's a pretty good running average there, 7 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think you'd take that every time, wouldn't you?
Yeah, it'll work.
Yeah, why not? First and 10 for the Z's, and now we got an official timeout. Again, 7.5 minutes to play in the first quarter.
Oh,
left. 7.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. No score. Rochester the football. First and 10 at the Northfield 36-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field. Heckathorn and Bennett go split to the right side. Shane is tight right. Eye back formation for John Hunting, who's now under center. Hadeshell dots the eye. Hunting takes a snap. Hands off to Hadeshell up the middle. Jacob Hadeshell fights for yards, gets it inside the 35, and the mark on this side gives him the 33-yard line, giving 3. It'll be 2nd and 7. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Rochester driving here on this their first series of the game. It'll be 2nd and 7. As Bennett and Heckathorn split to the right, which is the Rochester sideline. Kistler tight left, eye backs again. Hunting takes the gives the handoff to Hadeshell, spins away from a couple of tacklers, and drags 3 or 4 tacklers up to the 31-yard line, so giving 2 more, and it'll be 3rd and 5 for the Zebra offense.
Yeah, that run was all Hadeshell's. The Norseman had men in the backfield.
Yep.
That play seemed to kind of take off in slow motion. And
then on top of it, Hunting and Hadeshell run into each other in the backfield.
Right.
3rd and 5 for the Z's at the Northfield, a 31-yard line. Again, going to our left. We're down to 6.5 to play in the first quarter. No score here at Northfield. Bennett will be tight to the right. Shane tight left. The flanker to the left side is Heckathorn. On 3rd and 5, Hunting under center. Split backs behind him. Heckathorn goes in motion to the right side. Gets a pitch going right. Cuts it back inside. Now cuts it back outside. Takes it to the 25, maybe to the 24. And if that's the mark, that'll be enough for Zebra first down. Giving 7 on the play. It'll be 1st and 10 for the Z's inside the 25.
You know, we've talked about Heckathorn and Bickle for Northfield averaging over 7 yards each time they touch the ball. Heckathorn averaging more than 11 yards every time he touches the football.
course, it's now with only seven, it's make his average go down a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. Maybe down to 10 yards a carry.
Knight's still young for him.
Yeah. Heckathorn split to the near side, wide side of the field. Bennett split right. Ibacks for Hunting inside the 25 in Northfield. They got the ball in the far hash. Here's the snap. The handoff goes to Hadashell. Shakes one tackler and his ankle tackled at the 21-yard line. Give him three. It'll be second and seven for Rochester, methodically moving it down the field. Of course, this drive starting on the 50-yard line after after the punter was stopped short of the first down. And Rochester took over in very good field position, and now they have it second and seven at the Northfield 21. No score here at Northfield, 5:25 to play in the first quarter. Shane is tight right, Bennett tight left, flanker to the right side is Heckathorn, I-back formation for Hunting. On second and seven, here's a snap. Heckathorn gets it coming around the left side on the counter play, and he gets him a yard. It'll be second down and make that third down and six after a one-yard play. Northfield not fooled on that formation and not fooled on that counter by the Zebra offense.
Well, we may see what Hunting's got in an arm right here.
It's Mr. 6'3 Bennett, I hope.
Which they did not look for him very often last week.
No. Nope,
they're going to split him out.
Wide to the right, Heckathorn wide to the left. Offset to the right are the Zebras. Hunting back to throw, quickly on the out to Bennett. It was a good throw off his fingertips, incomplete. It'll be fourth and six, and probably on the 20-yard line, you go for it. However, Mr. Lee, Wilson Lee, was hitting 35-yarders in pregame.
Yeah, he was. I don't know that he's come out.
He will not come out. Rochester will go for it on fourth and six. Either way, playing the field position here.
Well, they had Bennett wide open in the flats. He was going to be short of the first down, but all he had to do was catch the football.
Yeah. Fourth and six for Rochester. Heckathorn wide to the right side. Two tight ends for the Zebras. Hunting under center on fourth and six from the Northfield 20. The snap. Pitches to Hadashell on the reverse. Has a blocker in front. Does Heckathorn. Heckathorn, oh, runs into his own player. But he dives to the 15, and he is going to be short. Man, that was wide open, and Northfield did a fantastic job shutting that down as Heckathorn had a blocker in front of him that was Hunting, and he could not get to the first down marker. He got five, and that's it. It'll be first and 10 for Northfield at their own 15.
So both offenses have a little bit of success moving the football. They both stall out and turn the ball over on downs.
First and 10 for the Northfield Norse at their own 15-yard line, ball in the near hash. Wide to the left side is Brown. Wide to the near side is Kendall. Your fullback is Bickle with Frieden. Under center, he brings the club to the line of scrimmage. Feiger goes in motion to the right side, and Lee is jumps off sides. That'll give him a free five. It'll be first and five at the 20.
Zebra's trying to anticipate the snap, and Friedman doing a good job of seeing the blitz coming and delays his count.
Yep.
And gets him off sides.
If you're not 100% concentrated, those linemen, they start with their hands on their knees, stand up, and then go down to the three-point stance. And I mean, it does get confusing.
Well, and the thing is, the linemen are a good yard and a half off the football.
Uh-huh.
So if you're looking at them trying to judge the line of scrimmage, you're going to be off sides.
Frieden try to give the hard count to draw the Zebras off sides on first and five. Frieden on the option, gives to Bickle, spins away, and gets up at the 25. And he is going to be, oh boy, that's going to be close. He's going to be right at the sticks. Ball to 25, give him five. It'll be first and 10 for the Northfield Norse.
Northfield has ran seven plays now total this game, and five of them have been right up the middle. So
yeah,
maybe they found that little weakness in the Zebras we were talking about.
Well, in three games, you can see why Mr. Bickle runs the ball 63 times, because he's good for four or five a carry.
Well, he's averaging seven.
Yeah. First and 10 for Northfield at their own 25. Frieden under center. Kendall in motion, the quick hitter to Viger. Viger's got a first down and breaks loose. Viger at the 45 of Rochester, the 40. Stiffs arm to the 35 and carries the Zebras inside the 30-yard line. And then a little extra activity by Hadashell is going to give him 15 more on top of that. So he gets it to the 30, and then we're going to have an unsportsmanlike on Jacob Hadashell. Is going to carry him to the 16-yard line, first and 10 for Northfield.
You could tell that receiver, he had Hadashell's hand in his face mask. It looked like Hadashell might have been a little irritated.
Well, the problem is Hadashell chucked him about 10 yards out of bounds.
Yeah,
that's the problem.
Well, that's a 45-yard pass play with a 15-yard penalty at the end.
So they're going to mark it from the 31 up to the 16 after the 15-yard mark off. So And that pass play went for what, 3 yards?
It was a 3-yard pass that went for 44 yards. Yep.
So first and 10 for Northfield at the Rochester 16-yard line. Ball in the near hash with 4 minutes to play in the first quarter. Kendall wide to the near side, which is the short side of the field for Northfield. Brown split left. Short is the left flanker, the left wing back, and Viger is the right wing back. Frieden sets a line of scrimmage. Short comes in motion to the near side. And now resets on the left side of the line. Frieden under center again. Short on the motion to this side. On the option, Viger make that. Bickle has it. Bickle over the right side of the line. He gets inside the 10 down to around the 8 or 9 yard line, giving the 9. It'll be a pickup of 7, so it'll be second down and 3 for Northfield inside the Rochester 10. 3:45 to play, first quarter, no score. Northfield knocking on the door here at home. Second and 3 for the Norse. Ball at the Rochester 9 yard line. Kendall wide to the near side. Frieden sets a club with 10 on the play clock. Byer goes in motion left on the keeper. Frieden keeps it left side and is driven backwards. Nice job by the Zebras. Matt Abbott was there.
Connor McLaughlin is one of them.
And also John Hunting there to drive, to stop Frieden. No law or no gain. It'll be second down and three, or make that third and 3. Under 3 minutes to play, first quarter. Northfield third and 3 at the Rochester 9-yard line. Wide to the left side for Northfield is Brown. Kendall split to the right. Left wing back is Short. Right wing back is Viger. Frieden sets the line of scrimmage. Viger in motion to left side, and we Northfield
got,
jumps.
Yep, we got motion on Northfield.
And that'll back him up 5, so that'll be 3rd and 8 after the false start whistled against Northfield.
You know, I mentioned that the Northfield linemen, they're a good yard and a half off the football. When they go up to the line of scrimmage, Friedman, the quarterback's actually standing forward of his offensive line.
Yeah, you're right. So it'll be 3rd and 8 for Northfield back at the Rochester 14-yard line with 2:45 to play in the first quarter. Frieden brings a club to the line of scrimmage. Kendall wide to the right side, which is the wide side of the field. Frieden sets the line of scrimmage and the fullback Bickle. Short comes in motion to the near side. Back to pass is Frieden. He is hit and dropped. Wes Beck.
Nice
the
job.
First man to hit him right there at the 25. The 24 is driven backwards, so he's going to lose about 10 yards. And now it will be 4th and about 18 for the Northfield Norse.
Great job by Wes Beck. He timed that blitz perfectly, and he come through untouched right at the snap of the football. And Friedman didn't have any option except to just try and get away, and in the process loses 10 yards.
That's what's nice on the defensive side. You have a position player that is your main focus, and Beck said was the quarterback.
Yep.
So option or not, he was going to hit Frieden.
4th and 18 for Northfield at the Rochester 24. Frieden, back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Throws down the near side. He's got a receiver. Bennett right there and knocks it down.
Great heads up play by Bennett. Rather than get the interception at the goal line, he just sticks his big old hand up there and swats it to the ground.
Lesson learned.
Yes, lesson learned. We saw that in week 2 against Plymouth, where they went for the interception on 4th down and had the ball at the 1 yard line. This time, they listened to the coaching and on 4th down and long, they swat the ball to the ground.
So Rochester, instead of taking over at their 1, will now have it 1st and 10 at their 24-yard line going to our left. Hadashell and Beck offset to the right side. Two receivers to the right as Bennett and Heckathorn. Hunting under center on 1st and 10. Hunting takes a snap, gives to Beck. Wes Beck, a couple of tacklers across the 30, down to the 31. Gain of about 6. It'll be that's going to be a gain of about 7. It'll be 2nd and 3 as the ball is carried out to the 31-yard line with 90 seconds to play. First quarter, no score here at Northfield.
No score, like you said, but there's been three times they've all been close.
Yeah. Bennett wide to the near side, which is the short side of the field. Heckathorn split right. Split backs again for Hunting. Kistler is tied into the right side. Hunting under center with 1:10 to play in the first quarter on 2nd down and 3. Back to passes. Hunting has a slant. That's Bennett. It's caught. Bennett with a defender on his back breaks loose. Bennett down the far side of the 30. Cuts back at the 35, the 25, and inside the 25-yard line to the, about the 20-yard line. I think that's going to be pass interference.
I would agree with you.
There's a flag in the play. Bennett carries that down to the 20-yard line of Northfield, and I think that's going to be declined. I think that that's going to be pass interference on Northfield, and that's going to be first and 10 for the Zebras at the 20-yard line. We'll wait and see.
That's a 48-yard pass play if it stays from Hunting to Bennett.
It will be against Northfield. It will be declined, and it'll be a first down for Rochester at the 20 of the Northfield Norris with 58 seconds to play in the first quarter.
Could you get any more two mirrored football programs than these two? Both of their first two offensive possessions have almost been identical.
Yeah. And here's the thing. That slant, Trav, has been open every game,
every week.
It's hard to stop, especially with the 6'3 receiver like Bennett. I mean, that's like you said, that slant is wide open. If they have to go over the top, his defensive back's 5'10 on him.
Heckathorn gets another jet sweep. He's got a blocker, Heckathorn, in front of him. Might make that out of shell. Heckathorn kicks it outside, and it is driven hard out of bounds at the 10.
Good block on the outside by Gavin Bennett as well. He had that defensive back secured the entire time.
Heckathorn gains 10 on the play, though.
Getting his average back up.
It's going to be just, they're not going to give him the first down, though. It's going to be just outside the 10.
And it's going to be just shy. Yep, about a foot to go, maybe a little more. 45 seconds to play in the first quarter. Rochester has it second and inches at the 10-yard line. Heckathorn wide to the right side, wide side of the field. Bennett split to the near side, split backs for Hunting. Hunting takes a snap going right. He's got a first down. Hunting driving his way to the 9. There wasn't a lot there, but enough to get a Zebra first down. It'll be first and goal from about the 9, maybe the 8.
Yeah, I was back on the ball carrier.
First and goal from the 8 for the Rochester Zebras with 40 seconds to play in the first quarter. Shane brings a play in from the sideline. Ball in the near hash. Clock rolls. This will probably be the last play of the first quarter, and unless it's going to be an incomplete pass. Bennett wide to the right side. Heckathorn, the flanker, to the left. Under 30 seconds to play, first quarter, no score. Rochester knocking on the door from the 9.
Jump ball
first and goal.
Zone.
Heckathorn gets the pitch going right. He's got some blockers, looking to outrun the defense at the sideline. He turns the corner, dives for the end zone. Does he get in? No signal yet. He got to the pylon. Touchdown, Zebras! An 8-yard touchdown run by Jay Heckathorn puts the Zebras on the scoreboard first.
Well, everybody had their hands up except the guys that matter, and they had to think about it. They finally give him the touchdown. Great job by Heckathorn, and a great job by the right side of that Rochester line, holding their blocks long enough to let Heckathorn get around the corner.
And it was just a race in the end zone. Then Heckathorn was going wide to the right side, just using the speed to get around every defensive guy out there, and it worked.
I didn't think he was going to win the foot race to the sideline, but he did. Extra point coming. Abisher Holder, snap is back, hold is down, kick is blocked, and no good. 15 seconds to play, first quarter. We'll take a 30-second timeout. Rochester up 6-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 15 seconds to play in the first quarter. Rochester strikes first.
5 plays, 76 yards, capped off by Jay Heckathorn, 8-yard touchdown run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was actually blocked. Zebra's lead 6-0 with 15 seconds to go in the first quarter.
So Rochester and Wilson Lee will kick off to Northfield. Back deep is Short and Viger. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Fourth game of the regular season. Homecoming at Rochester next week.
Doesn't seem like it's that time of year already.
I think we're at the time of year where we might see some snowflakes tonight. Good heavens. Light a fire on my backside. It's chilly out here. Wilson Lee, high end over end kick. Short kick bounces and goes out of bounds. So Northfield will start, what, at the 35?
Mm-hmm.
Not exactly what they're
looking for. 15 seconds to play, first quarter. Rochester up 6-0.
Yeah, what were you saying? 45 degrees cooler tonight than it was last Friday?
That's exactly right.
Yeah.
So if there's any listeners over on the Zebra sideline, I'll take a hot chocolate.
Yeah, I'm sure there's a couple.
Well, there's no movement, so.
Yeah. I got a feeling if it was at home and you asked for a hot chocolate, there'd be no movement. First and 10 for Northfield at their own 35-yard line. Ball in the near hash. Frieden under center. Bickle behind him. Short comes in motion to the near side. Frieden tries to draw the Zebras off of offsides again. Now back under center after the hard count. Short in motion. on the option. Bickle has it, stood up after a couple of yard gain and driven backwards. And that'll do it probably for the first quarter as Bickle gets it out to about the 38-yard line, a gain of three. It'll be second down and seven for Northfield. When we come back after one, the Zebras lead 6-0. You're listening to Rochester Football, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Meet Bob and Stan. Both bought new TVs. Stan watches all the popular ringside live events, boxing, wrestling, and the big fight. Bob can't. Stan gets out-of-market sports packages of baseball, hockey, and basketball. Bob can't. Stan gets live concerts and the hottest Hollywood hits. What's the difference? Stan uses InDemand's pay-per-view for all the special events, sports programs, and the newest movie releases. So call RTC today and start your own pay-per-view experience.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
The far hash, which is the Rochester sideline. Brad Thomas, Travis Swattering, I'm David Musselman. And quickly, Northfield on the football. They have twins on the near side, two receivers. Frieden sets a line of scrimmage, including the fullback, Josh Bickle. Beyer gives a motion to the near side on the option. Bickle has it. Bickle twists his way to the 40. A couple of the yards there. It'll be third down and five for Northfield. Actually, giving third and four, it'll be a another three-yard pickup. So third and four for Northfield. Ball on the Rochester side of the 40.
Local TRC score right now is Wabash leads North Miami 7-6.
Yeah.
One of those two teams is going to get their first win of the season.
It's brilliant.
I was just saying.
Yes, it's not me getting made fun of.
Yeah, you'll get your chance again. I'm done for the year for Brad. Third and four. On the pitch out, Biker gets a high pitch, grabs it, tries to cut back, and loses yards as he is stopped back at about the 38-yard line, and that'll bring up fourth down at about seven for Northfield as, boy, Rochester does such a good job. Their speed strings things out so well that I think right now Bickle is the only bright spot for the Norse.
Yeah, he's 26 yards on seven carries, a little below his average, but you got to figure that sooner or later he's going to find an opening.
Yeah. Like you said, though, that pitch was high. I didn't give any time for that back to receive it and try to use his speed. You're fine.
Barry back to kick the ball away. Heckathorn stands at his 30. Barry, no rugby kick this time. Heckathorn muffs it. Still loose.
Rochester
going to fall on it.
Wow.
Hunting was right there to fall on a loose football. Northfield had two opportunities to come up with a muffed kick, or the muffed handle, I should say.
Well, Heckathorn just took his eyes off the ball at the last minute. Bobbled it a couple times, and then Northfield right there to knock him away from the football.
Wow.
Luckily for Rochester, Hunting came back and fell on it.
That's back-to-back weeks now with Heckathorn.
Two muffs. I think that he wants to run it so bad. I think that he thinks that everybody wants him to run it so bad. He takes off before he's got the football secured, and that's going to have to change. I mean,
there's no reason
to put him back there with all that speed if
he can't use it.
Yeah, that's right. So Rochester first and 10. At their own 27-yard line, Hunting back to pass, looks left, throws to Benham on the far sideline. He reaches up to grab it, and incomplete. Nice defense on that far side by Frieden of Northfield. Knocks the pass away, which is a little bit underthrown as well, because I think if they threw it more to the sideline, Bennett catches it, and he's gone.
Yeah, I think so, too. Bennett had to almost come to a complete stop in order to either try and jump over the defender or at least bat the ball away. And
yeah, Bennett, you're right. Bennett turned in kind of to the defensive back there.
Yeah.
They looked at Bennett now three times, which is, I think, this whole amount of times they looked at him last week total. So
yeah.
I like that, though. I like the throw into him, he's 6'3", 3-4 inches taller than every defensive back.
At some point, you can start to use him as a decoy.
Yeah.
So second and 10. Hadashell goes in motion to the left side. Eckethorn gets it, shakes a tackler, still on his feet, and then finally tackled back at the 20-yard line. So the Zebras are going to lose 7 yards, and that'll bring up third and 17 for Rochester.
Well, now they'll be looking for anybody they can throw the football to.
Give him third and 18 because it's at the 19-yard line.
Northfield doing a great job that time. When Heckathorn went in motion, the entire defense shifted, and they knew what was coming. Heckathorn got the football, and there was no place for him to go. And when he turned around to come back, it was all blue shirts.
You know what I haven't seen a whole lot yet this year? I'm not sure at all. A screen.
Yeah.
Bennett goes split left, wide side of the field. Heckathorn split to the right side. 9:40 to play, first quarter. Back to passes, Hunting. There it is.
There it is.
There's the screen.
You asked for it.
Blockers in front of him. Schaefer's in front of Hadashell. Hadashell spins away from one Northfield tackler and then takes it out to the 35-yard line. He picks up 15 yards, and that'll be fourth and about 2, maybe 3 yards to go for Rochester. And this will be an interesting call.
Kind of got to like the opportunity that they get here.
Go for it.
Yeah, I think it would be, except they haven't moved the sticks yet. Was there a flag?
There is a flag right back there at the 10-yard line.
Oh, that's not good. That's in the Rochester backfield.
But
I think that
they're talking to. Yeah, they're going to be roughing the passer on Northfield. They're talking to Rochester captains.
That'll be a first down.
Yep.
That's what I noticed. They're just talking to Hunting the whole time.
Personal foul, roughing the passer against Northfield. So
take that decision out of the coach's hands.
From the 15-yard line, takes it out to the 49 of the Zebras. So they've got it first and 10. Now at their 49-yard line. It would have been an interesting call there.
Yeah,
Rochester picked up 15 of the 17 yards, which would have been fourth and two, but because of the roughing the passer penalty, gives him first down plus an extra 15 yards. So first and 10 for Rochester at their own 49-yard line. Ball in the far hash. Heckathorn wide to the right side, the wide side of the field. Bennett split left, split backs for Hunting. Kistler is tight right. Under center is John Hunting. Here's a snap. Gives to Beck. Beck has stood up the backfield and driven backwards.
Wow.
Nice job by
number 32,
Kimble.
Bryce Kendall. He almost picked West Beck up there,
yeah.
I think.
That was an impressive tackle.
Absolutely.
Actually, no yards on the carry. No loss either, for that matter. It'll be second and 10.
Northfield was showing a nice little blitz there, too.
Yeah. Under 9 minutes of play, first half. Rochester up 6-0. Second down and 10. And now we're going to have an official timeout as Bickle's having a helmet issue. Now we're ready. Middle linebacker is Bickle. Rochester second and 10 at their own 49. Split backs for Hunting. Back to pass. Looks to the near side on the slant over the head of Heckathorn.
Wow, Heckathorn would probably have been better off. He'd have just gone straight downfield instead of slanting inward,
yep,
as that ball was kind of floated on Hunting and came to the outside.
Fortunately, it was too high for the defensive back, too.
It almost looked like he was actually looking for Bennett there, just how high he threw
that
ball.
Yeah.
When you throw it a 6-3 three times in a row, it might be hard throwing a Heckathorn like that.
Well, especially when he doesn't have the inside position.
Yeah.
Like I think that Hunting thought he was going to have there.
Yeah.
Third and 10 for Rochester. Ball at their own 49-yard line. Shotgun now is Hunting. Beck to his left, Hadashell to his right. Watch the draw, third and 10. Hunting takes a snap, back to pass. Here comes another wide receiver screen. Heckathorn gets it and laid out. And it's intercepted. Intercepted by Northfield. And he is tackled by Hunting. A touchdown saving tackle at the 31-yard line. And that was intercepted by Jensen Frieden.
And that was again, though, Heckathorn. He caught the football and was hit almost immediately, but it was as if he just threw the football backwards over his head. The ball never, you know, if this was college, you'd be running the replay and challenging that to see if he even had possession, if his foot ever came down on the ground to qualify as possession.
Yeah. It was an interception. He went up high to grab the ball and then hit in the lower back, and as he got hit, the ball popped up in the air, and Jensen Frieden, Johnny on the spot, returned it back to his 31-yard line. So Northfield in business here. Frieden under center, sets the line. Beiger comes in motion to the near side, fakes the pitch, rolls right as Frieden. Frieden flips it out to Bickle. It's complete, and Bickle takes it to the 25-yard line, a pickup of about 6. And that'll be second down and 4 with 8:20 to play in the first half, with Rochester leading 6-0. Northfield knocking on the door again.
Heckathorn, he's still out there, but my gosh, that was one of the hardest hits I've seen all year.
That was a big hit.
He got drilled.
And again, Hunting's pass a little high.
Yeah, a little high.
So Kimball wide to the right, wide to the right side. Frieden sets a club. Fire comes in motion to the near side. On the option, Frieden keeps. Frieden up the middle. And he gets it about to the 22, a pickup of three. And that'll be third down and one for Northfield inside the Rochester 25 at the 22. 7.5 minutes of play in the first half. Brown comes in, brings a play from the sideline. Kendall comes out for Northfield. Third and one for the Norse, ball in the far hash. Needs to get to the Rochester 21 for the first down. Brown split to the near side, wide side of the field. Frieden with eight on the play clock, sets a club. Feiger in motion to the near side. Back to pass is Frieden, throws to the near side. It is incomplete. Boy, he got lucky as that intended for Brown. And that one, too, floated
out of bounds. Yeah, over everybody's head.
Brown and Hunting just looked up and watched that ball fly over their heads.
Third and one. Would you expect anything else than 44 here?
Oh, no. 1 yard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He'll pick up five.
Maybe a quarterback sneak, but
no way.
I'm going with your boy.
Rochester's got Rochester's got four defenders right across the front of the football.
I think that's probably where they need to be.
They know that they're looking for Bickle as well.
Fourth and one for Northfield at the Rochester 22-yard line. Kendall, make that to Frieden under center. Feiger in motion to the near side. On the option, Bickle carries the club to the 21, and it looks like that's going to be enough for the first down. Is that Bickle? Yeah, I wasn't sure if Bickle or Frieden carried it. I think actually what happened, I think Bickle carried the ball and Frieden to the 21.
I agree with you. I think Friedman was trying to hold that ball in there just as long as he could, and he ended up just going for the ride.
First and 10 for Northfield at the Rochester 21-yard line. 7 minutes of play in the first half. Again, Rochester up 6-0. Ball on the far hash for Northfield. Brown will come split to the near side. Viger, the white right wing back. Short the left wing back. He's in motion to the right side. Is short on the option. Frieden carries around the right side. Frieden, and then is driven out of bounds by, looked like Bennett on far side. Who was that?
Bennett.
Was it?
Yeah.
Okay. So he carries the ball inside the 15 to about the 14-yard line. A pickup of about seven. Second and three now for Northfield. With 6:45 to play in the first half, they do what they're doing. You know, they're doing what they do, and they just run the ball.
You're right; they're doing it very well.
And when they fool the defense, I mean, those passes are complete for the most part.
Yeah. Second down and three for Northfield inside the Rochester 15-yard line. 6:45 to play, first half. Frieden keeps it, and Beck smacks him to the ground. Gain of nothing. It'll be third and about three for the Norse. Wes Beck, again, meeting Frieden. Yeah, they're going to lose a yard, Brad. There's going to be back to the 15, so it'll be second and to make that third and four. With 6:25 to play in the first half. Again, Rochester up 6-0. Pretty quick first half here at Northfield High School. Ball on the far hash for Northfield. Brown comes to the near side, wide side of the field. Down to 15 on the play clock. 6 minutes to play in the game, or in the first half, I should say. Viger in motion to the near side. On the end around. Oh, short had it. He fumbled it. Ball still loose. Rochester picks it up. That was a touchdown all day long. And we had some extracurricular activity on that far side. I think Harper was mixed up in that.
Yeah, Coach Zander come right out and jerked him off the football field.
If short holds onto the ball, he walks into the end zone.
Easy. Had a shell with the recovery on the fumble.
So both teams now with the turnover.
First and 10 for Rochester at the fumble recovery at their own 21-yard line. That play was designed perfectly. Had Rochester flowing to the right, the ball was flowing to the left, coming back to the right for Northfield, and there wasn't anybody in front of short, but the end zone. Under 6 minutes to play, first half. Rochester has another own 21. Hunting to Hattishell. Hanischel, left side, grabbed by the ankles, falls to the 25, giving the 26. It'll be a pickup of 5 and second down and 5 with the clock rolling. Ball in the far hash here for Rochester. They're going to our right.
This would be a perfect drive for the Zebras to go down and score, take a 2-touchdown lead, and get the ball back in the second half.
Yep.
You can't ask for more, much more than that.
Second and 6 for Rochester. Twins on the near side. That's Bennett and Heckathorn. Spybacks for Hunting. Kistler's tight right. Ball in the far hash. Hunting flips it to Hadashell. Hadashell cuts it back to the middle of the field. Dodges some tacklers. Hadashell with a tackler on top of him. Gets into the 45, outside the 45 to the 47. Giving 21 yards on the run. It'll be first and 10 for the Z's at their own 47-yard line.
Nice job by Jacob Hadashell. He managed to cut back against the grain and get behind the blockers.
Yeah, good job by his man blocker right there. It was 58, Jordan Schaefer, who snuck behind him the entire ride.
That's a good bike. I could handle running behind Schaefer.
I would do that too.
Yeah. He'd have to wait for me though. First and 10 for Rochester at their own 47. 5:10 to play in the first half. Ball in the middle of the field. Chain still trying to get set over there on the far side. Bennett split left. Heckathorn is the flanker to the left side. Split backs for Hunting. Pitches again, this time to Beck. Beck going left with blockers. Beck spins inside the 50. Gets to the north field 49, maybe the 48. Nice job by Wes Beck carrying it to the north field 49-yard line. Giving 4, it'll be 2nd and 6. 4:45 to play. In the first half, Rochester up 6-0. Brad Thomas, Travis Watring, I'm David Musselman. Heckathorn wide to the near side, which is the wide side of the field. Bennett split left, I-backs for Hunting with Kistler tight right. From the north field 49, Heckathorn make that Hadashell, gets the carry, he sides it, steps the tackler. Heckathorn
almost
loses
the football.
Rochester looks like they get on it, the bing bag is thrown. Northfield says they have it,
Flags coming in late.
No indication of if Northfield has it. They do say they've got it. Northfield says they've got it. No indication yet from the officials who has the football. And it looks like Rochester will keep possession at the Northfield 31-yard line. But like we said, there was a flag on the play.
20-yard gain by Hadashell. He was just on the verge of breaking that open when he got tripped up. And on the way to the ground, he dropped the football.
And that'll be...
What was that? Block in the back?
It looked like a personal foul.
I think it is.
I think it is. I'm just curious.
Yeah, it was 51 Tanner Music, it looked like.
It was really late. It was almost at the very end of the play.
Yeah, I
saw. So Rochester keep possession, but after the penalty, it pushes the ball back to their own 46-yard line. So that'll be, second down and about.
So they're going to have a net
11.
Loss of 4 yards.
Five.
So
yep.
5 yards. Hadashell gains 20. The penalty is 10 yards beyond the line of scrimmage, and you march off 15 yards and end up losing 5.
So it'll be 2nd and 11 for Rochester, back at their own 46-yard line with 4:19 to play in the first half. Again, Rochester leading 6-0. Now the officials will converge and talk, and I think Coach Zahner wants to talk to the head official, the referee.
If nothing else, he wants to know who the penalty was on.
Yeah. Rochester will have Heckathorn wide to the right, Bennett split left. Beck and Hadashell in the I formation with Shane tied to the right. Hunting, hands off to Hadashell going left. Hadashell met at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. It'll be 3rd and 10 for Rochester, maybe 3rd and 11.
I think that was the exact same play that they just ran. This time, Northfield, a much better job defending.
Yeah, right on.
Well, I mean, like we say, when it's broke, don't fix it. I mean, that first play, it was ran perfectly other than the penalty at the end.
3rd and 11 for Rochester. 3:45 to play first half, leading 6-0. Bennett, Heckathorn wide to the near side. Kistler will be tight left. Hadashell dots the eye. Hunting under center with 15 on the play clock. On 3rd and 11 from their own 46, Hunting back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Hunting not going to get away with it. Hunting is sacked in the backfield, back at the 36-yard line. Give him the 37. He's going to lose 9.
And that time, Hunting didn't have any time to set up. As he drops back, the defense comes with him. It almost looked like they were trying to set up a screen.
That's exactly what it looked like, as fast as the defense except, in the backfield.
Except I think Hunting was looking downfield.
Yeah. So it'll be fourth down and 20 after a 9-yard loss, and Wes Beck will stand back at his 25-yard line to punt this one away. Jared Short stands inside his 25 to receive the punt from Wes Beck. 2:50 to play, first half. Snap goes to Beck. Here comes some pressure. He gets it away. End over end kick. Short takes it at the 27. Short is then driven down by Schaefer with a no gain.
Right at the 26-yard line.
No return by Northfield. Good job by Schaefer. Nice open field tackle. And Northfield will start at their own 27 with 2:42 to play in the first half.
Yeah, I'm not sure what Short was thinking there. I mean, as soon as he caught that ball, Schaefer was waiting for him.
Nice job by Schaefer.
Yeah, absolutely. He got down there real quick.
And then made a great open field tackle. You're right.
I think he is he the long punter? Or the long snapper? Yeah. I think he is.
First and 10 for Northfield at their 27-yard line, going to our left. Frieden sets a line. Short goes in motion to the right. Fakes the pick. Here comes some pressure. Frieden just gets rid of it and underthrows his receiver. It'll be second and 10, which is probably the best scenario, the best case scenario there.
Good pressure by the Zebras right up the middle. Yep. Again, with another blitz.
34, Connor McLaughlin was right there the entire
right.
time.
So it'll be second and 10 with 2:37 to play in the first half. Northfield with the football at their own 27, going to our left. Northfield on the ball with 20 on the play clock. Frieden directs traffic to the line of scrimmage. Now sets the group. Fire in motion to the near side on the option. Bickle takes it to the 30. Giving three, it'll be third and 7 with 2.5 to play in the first half. And now we're going to have a timeout, Rochester. The Zebras will use their first. 2.5 to play in the first half. Rochester leading 6-0. You're listening to Zebra Football on 92.1 WROI. 2.5 minutes to play in the first half. Rochester uses their first of three timeouts, leading 6-0. Northfield has it third and 7 at their 30-yard line, going to our left. Short goes in motion right. Fakes pitch to Frieden. Throws back to the Bickle. Bickle has the carry. Bickle at the 35. Tries to pop it out at the 40. Lunges forward at the 41. And that's going to be a first down for Northfield. Giving 10 yards on the pitch and catch. Great job by Northfield on the screen.
A lot of running by Bickle just to pick up those 10 yards after the pass.
And then Hunting about had him before the first down marker. Yep. He threw Hunting down. Well, ran over him.
First and 10 for Northfield at the 40-yard line with 2:15 to play in the first half. Ball in the near hash. Kendall wide to the right side for Northfield. Frieden under center.
Fumble.
Football. Ball loose. Rochester says they have it. And they do have it. Rochester, the back quarterback center snap. Frieden couldn't handle the snap, and Rochester takes over at their own 40 after the fumble recovery. Another fumble recovery.
Harper on that recovery this time.
So Rochester with two timeouts and 2:08 to play in the first half has an opportunity here to put some points on the board before halftime, already up 6-0.
I think their best field position since the first drive
that they
took down inside the 20.
Yep. And stalled.
Right.
Bennett wide to the right side, which is the short side of the field. Flanker to the right is Hadashell. Flanker left is Heckathorn. Lone back is Beck. And now Northfield will use a timeout. 2:08 to play in the first half. Rochester up 6-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 2:08 to play in the first half. Rochester will have the football.
Sorry, some local scores. Conference, Wabash and North Miami are tied 14-14 in the second. Winnemac leads South Newton 7-0.
That just started about 2 minutes ago.
Another one that's in the first half. Pioneer leads Caston 35-0. And then Jimtown has a season high in the first quarter, 7-0 over
season
Knox.
Season high points. I'm guessing that they'll probably triple or quadruple that.
Val said they have 19 on the season.
Heckathorn, I make that Hadashell gets the carry, and he is driven down by the shirt tail. By the shirt tail, I should say. At the 40, they're just going to get nothing on that, are the Zebras, and it'll bring up second and 10 under 2 minutes to play in the first half.
Boy, the Norse defense, they do not lose track of Jacob Hadashell. They know where he's at. whether he's standing still or in motion.
Second week in a row, the opponent is blowing up our line of scrimmage.
I was going to say, I don't know if they're blowing up line of scrimmage or blitzing a lot, but either way, they're getting in our backfield real quick.
Bennett split left, Heckler split right. Second down and 10, I-backs for Hunting. John under center, pitches to Hattishell, fakes a handoff to Heckathorn, keeps it, and is going to lose a yard. Nobody fooled there wearing blue. And Kendall was the tackler there, brought down Hattishell single-handedly, third down at 11 with a minute 15 to play in the first half.
You know, Coach Brandon Baker, when he said in pregame, his linebackers are going to keep their eye on Hattishell the entire night, and I think they worked on that well this week.
Yeah.
They are all over him.
Third and 11 for Rochester. Heckathorn split left, wide side of the field. Bennett split to the right, down to 15 on the play clock and under a minute to go in the game clock. Out of the shotgun, Hunting back to pass, looks left, throws left, has Hattishell. Heckathorn, it is incomplete. That ball was tipped around three or four times, and Heckathorn tried to get it as on his way down to the ground, and it'll bring up fourth down and 11.
Some waters if you guys want.
Not even Bennett wasn't even looked at on that. 50 seconds to play in the first half. Fourth and 11 for the Zebras at the Northfield 41-yard line, and it looks like Wes Beck will, well, he's standing like he's going to punt the ball away, and I don't know if that's a bad idea.
Northfield lining up inside their 10, but no, now
Rochester, Rochester's going to go formation. For it. Quickly, Hunting back to pass. Looks right, throws right. It's got Kissel on the seam, and he's incomplete, and he was laid out by Short, and it'll be first and 10 by for the Northfield Norris. Coach Zahner wants a flag for the hit. But that'll be first and 10 for Northfield at their own 41.
On third down, Hunting looks left. Bennett's on the right side. Fourth down, Bennett's on the left side, and he looks right.
46 seconds to play, first half. I don't get it.
First down.
First down for Northfield. Going to our left now. They've got two timeouts and 46 seconds to work with. Rochester up 6-0.
Probably see a couple Frieden passes here if they want to try to get a quick point.
Frieden under center. On the option, Bickle right up the middle. Bickle carries the Zeeberg tacklers out to the 48-yard line, giving seven. Clock rolls, and Northfield will use another timeout. When we come back, it'll be second down and three for Northfield at their own 48-yard line, trailing 6-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 38 seconds to play in the first half. Northfield to the football at their own 48-yard line, second down and three. Frieden under center, sets the line. Fire in motion to the right side, gets the pitch going right. He's going to pass.
Back pass.
Hiker rolling right. He throws it up for grabs and throws it at the track. Pike. Incomplete.
I think the Zebras did
great
a good
idea.
Job of seeing that coming.
Good idea on throwing it to the track.
Yeah.
His Northfield receiver was almost at the 15-yard line. That ball made it to about the 27-yard line.
Kendall was the intended receiver. It'll be third and three at the Northfield 48-yard line. Again, the Norris going to our left with 30.6 seconds to play in the first half. Not a lot of scoring. 15 seconds to go in the first quarter. Jay Heckathorn's 8-yard run is the difference right now, as Rochester leads 6-0.
Well, I think everybody knows who's getting the ball on this one.
You think?
Third and three.
Twins to the near side, the short side of the field for Frieden. On third down and three, under center. Takes a snap. On the option, Bickle gets it and is driven backwards. Giving the 49 a gain of one. It'll be fourth and two.
McLaughlin right there at the snap of the football for the Zebras.
We're under 15 seconds to play in the first half. And I don't think Coach Baker is going to run another play. I think I just saw him shake his head no, but maybe not. 10 seconds. Frieden still in the huddle with five. And that's going to do it. At halftime, the Rochester Zebras lead Northfield at Northfield High School 6-0. When we come back, first half stats after this on 92.1 WROI.
Daddy! What channel is the Family Network on?
We don't have that channel, Ma.
What channel is the Science Channel on?
We don't have that channel either, Ma.
How about the Hallmark Movie Channel?
Ma, we don't have any of those channels.
Well, why not?
Because we don't have digital tier.
So we don't have any of the digital tier channels?
Why do you think I'm always playing video games, Ma?
Because you don't have a girlfriend.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherd's help you find your next vehicle.
Deep. Hanischel takes it at the 18-yard line, hands off to Heckethorn going to the right. Now cuts it upfield. Heckethorn lowers his head and gets out to the 31-yard line. So that's where Rochester will take over as Hanischel handed it off to Heckethorn, and he went to the short side of the field. Heckethorn or Hanischel had a lot of room over here on the near side, but
yeah, he did.
Handed
they,
it off.
They ran the reverse. Going to try and get some speed in Heckethorn on the corners.
I almost wish he would have kept that ball.
Yeah.
He had a lot of room on the side.
So the Zebras will start at their own 31-yard line, leading 6-0 here in the third quarter. The ball on the far hash, and Hunting under center with Ibacks behind him. Heckethorn split to the near side, wide side of the field. Hunting under center on 1st and 10 from the zone 31. Hands off to Hadashell. Hadashell stacked up at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there. It'll be 2nd and 10.
The Zebras front five have got to do a better job this half than they did the first half of their blocking. The Norsemen are just getting in the backfield way too easy, and it's
yep.
not giving Heckethorn, Hadashell, Beck, I don't care who it is, it's not giving them enough time.
Blowing it up. 2nd down and 10 for the Zebras. Hadashell again over the right side, fights forward to maybe the 34-yard line. No, I beg your pardon, that was Beck. Wes Beck picks up 3. That'll bring up 3rd down and a short 7 for the Zebras. Well, we'll give him 3rd and 6 as he giving 4 gets into the 35. 3rd and 6 for Rochester. And they'll break the huddle. Ball on the basically the far side of the field. Heckethorn split to the near side. Hunting under center with backs behind him. Ibacks it is on 3rd and a long 6. Pitches to Hadashell. Hadashell looking for a block, looking to get the outside, and he's going to be caught by a wholesale of Northfield tacklers who drives him back to the 32-yard line. He's going to lose 3, and it'll bring up 4th down and 8.
Yeah, that time Northfield just did a great job of pursuing the football to the sideline. Hadashell getting to the outside, he had a blocker in front. But, boy, once that blocker got tied up with the defense, Hadashell didn't have any place to go. He couldn't get to the sideline. He tried to cut back, and the blue jerseys of Northfield in pursuit doing a great job.
Driscoll back deep along with Short for Northfield as Wes Beck stands at his 20-yard line looking to kick this one away. 3 and out for the Zebras on the first possession of the second half. A wobbly kick down the sideline, takes a Rochester bounce, and muffed it. Rochester picks it up on the
bad decision.
Return. Yeah,
there
bad
you go.
Decision. The bad
there
return by Northfield.
The ball come up short of the Northfield return man, and he tried to pick it up on the bounce, except the ball didn't bounce.
And Driscoll tried to short hop it.
Yeah.
Like Brad said, it didn't. It stayed low. He tried to grab the tip of it, and right through his hands, and right there, Rochester Zebras, Johnny on the spot.
McLaughlin on the recovery for Rochester.
So Rochester will take over inside the Northfield 35-yard line after the muff punt with under 10 minutes to play in the third quarter, leading 6-0. Hunting under center. Hadashell dots the eye. Takes a handoff going left. Hadashell at the 30. Carries a tackler inside the 30 to the 27.
going back to that punt, the first punt they had earlier, they picked it up and got drilled right away by Jordan Schaefer. And second time right there, McLaughlin's waiting for him as well. I don't know if they know how to fair catch it.
Wow. that's a type of punt that you just get away from.
Absolutely.
Live to fight another day.
Now, that time, Hanschel got some really decent blocking up front from that Rochester offensive line. He was able to pick up six or seven.
Yep. Second and three for Rochester. Heckethorn wide right, Bennett split left, down 10 on the play clock on second and three. Hadashell again right side. Hadashell's got a first down as he carries it inside the 25, giving the 24. Well, it's going to be close to the first down, I should say. It's right there at the line to gain. Ball is at the 24. The official stops the clock, looks down the way. Still looking down the way. And we're going to stretch the chains. So they'll bring the sticks across, and we'll measure here with 9:05 to play in the third quarter, with Rochester leading 6-0, ball at the 24-yard line, and they'll bring the chains across and measure.
Well, Rochester really needs to take advantage of this opportunity. You know that they had the ball to start the half and couldn't gain, 7 yards, let alone enough for the first down. Had to punt it away and get the gift.
Yeah. It's almost like that punt was like just a long pass.
Yeah.
You're right.
That's the way to look at it.
But they need to take advantage of it. They've had opportunities given to them before and have not been able to capitalize.
So give Hadashell, I don't know how you're going to do this, but give Hadashell 2 yards and 2 feet, 2 yards and 2.5 feet, because it's 3rd and inches for the Zebras with 9 minutes to play in the third quarter.
I don't know if there's a mercy rule or not, but Pioneer leads casting 56-0.
Yeah,
with the
uncle,
half.
Uncle, please. 24-yard line of the Zebras of Northfield. 3rd and inches for the offense. Hunting to Beck. Beck lowers his head, pushes the pile forward, still moving his feet, still getting yardage, and gets it to the 21, giving him 3. It'll be 1st and 10 for the Z's.
I didn't expect anything else right there. Give the ball to West Beck, let him put his head down, just go.
Rochester moving the football. They're at the Northfield 21-yard line, leading 6-0 with under 9 minutes to play in the third quarter. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Heckethorn goes split to the right side, two tight ends. Kistler to the right, Bennett to the left, I-backs for Hunting. John under center from the 21 of Northfield. Takes a snap, gives to Hadashell. Hadashell going left, cuts it back inside, and is tackled at the 15, giving him 6. It'll be 2nd and 4.
Good job by left side of that line now. The line's actually, they're picking up, doing a good job. Jordan Schaefer and Tanner Music were on those two main blockers there for Hadashell.
And it looks like, finally, the Rochester Zebras, they wanted to control the line of scrimmage, and it looks like on this drive, for the first time tonight, they're doing that.
Yeah, they've done a much better job here, at least in the last half dozen plays, than what they did in the first half.
And it shows being this close to in the red zone right now.
From the 15, Hadashell gets the carry. Hadashell's got a blocker right up the middle, untouched into the end zone. Touchdown, Zebras.
Nice job that time by Jacob Hadashell. All he had to do was just run through the hole that his offensive line created. 15 yards for the touchdown for Jacob Hadashell.
So Rochester now up 12-0. And
do you go for two now?
I think they're going to go for two. I don't see Wilson Lee in the game.
Yeah.
And I think the play did come in from the sideline. So Rochester will go for two
lob
with 8:04 to play.
Bennett wide here on the left.
Lob on up to Bennett, I think.
Hunting under center. Hadashell goes in motion to the right side. The two-point conversion. Back to pass is Hunting. Ugh. Had Hadashell in the flat and letting just a bit too much. No good. 12-0 Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 8:04 to play in the third quarter. The Rochester Zebras now up 12-0.
5 plays, 34 yards, capped off by a Jacob Hadashell, 15-yard touchdown. The two-point conversion the Zebras attempted was no good. Zebras lead 12-0 with 8 to go in the third quarter.
That touchdown run, it was almost like the parting of the Red Sea, because Hadashell was not touched.
It was. The Rochester offensive line did a great job that time of holding their blocks for Hadashell to get through there.
Short takes the return from the 36-yard line, carries it out. I'm sorry, from the 26-yard line and carries it out to about the 38. So that's where Northfield will start here on this drive with 8 minutes to play in the third, with the Zebras leading 12-0. And they'll start at their own 38-yard line, ball in the near hash.
A first half update. This week, I mean, it could be long past this, though. Was Valley 15, Southwood 13. Was the last we heard. That was a while ago.
Say that again.
15-13, Valley over Southwood. Okay. But that was a while ago, Val said.
So first and 10 for Northfield at their own 38-yard line. Frieden sets the club. Short on the comes in motion. The carry goes to Bickle over the right side of the line. Gets across the Northfield 40 to the 41, giving three. It'll be second and 7. Second down and 7 for Northfield at their own 41. Ball in the near hash. 7:35 to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester leading 12 to nothing. Kendall wide to the near side. Right wing back is Viger. Left wing back is Short. Again, Bickle is the fullback. Viger goes in motion to the left. On the option, Bickle takes it. Stacked up for a very little gain, if anything. Maybe a yard. It'll be third and 6 for Northfield.
McLaughlin and Heckathorn for the Zebras.
I'm not sure if Frieden really wants to give Bickle the ball there. I mean, I think it looks like to me he's fighting like crazy to take it out of his...
I agree with you. It looks like he wants to pull it back out and follow it.
Yeah.
Bickle stole it, and then Frieden gave a nice little push.
So third and 6 for Northfield at their own 42. Make that the 43. And Northfield on the ball with under 10 on the play clock. Kimball wide to the near side. Frieden sets the line with 5. With 4, there's the snap. Back to passes. Frieden, here comes some pressure on the backside. Frieden gets rid of it. Has an open receiver. And it's picked off by Bennett. Bennett picks it off at the 34 and carries it back to the 39.
Thank you.
And that's where the play ends at the 40-yard line. So Rochester, even though they had a receiver behind the defense, Bennett comes up with a huge interception, and Rochester will take over at their own 40.
Bennett using all of that 6'3".
Yeah.
Like you said, he let the receiver go behind him. The ball was a little bit underthrown, but Bennett's still able to jump up and pull that ball down it right in front of the receiver.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Z's at their own 40, leading 12 to nothing. The ball in the near hash will send Heckathorn wide to the right side. Bennett is tight left. Shane is tight right. High backs for Hunting. John under center on first down. Takes a snap, gives to Beck right up the middle. Beck spins away from a couple of tacklers. Second effort gets him a yard. It'll be second and 9. Again, Northfield blowing up the Rochester front 4-5. 6:08 to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester leading 12 to nothing. And they'll have a second down and 9 from their own 41-yard line going to our left. Bennett will go wide to the right side. Heckathorn is the flanker to the right. Split backs for Hunting. Tied into the right side is Shane. On second and 9, Hunting under center. Looks up and down the line, barks signals. And now the snap. There's a pitch to Beck going right. Beck, great kick out block in front of him to Hadashell. And then he is cut down at the 49-yard line, give him 8 on the pickup. And that'll bring up third down and a long one for the Rochester Zebras. Third and 1 for Rochester, now at their own 49-yard line. Great kick out block as that play developed by Jacob Hadashell.
Yeah, nice job by the Rochester line as they were able to turn that get the turn on that corner and keep off that backside pursuit of the Northfield defense.
Rochester on third and 1 will go to a straight T backfield. Hadashell right side. Jacob Hadashell's got a first down. Cuts it back inside, and he is tackled at the ankles, but not until he gets out to the Northfield 42-yard line. Be a pickup of about 9 yards and a Zebra first down.
They go to that straight T backfield. I think everybody in the whole entire field knows what's going on. It's going to be a rundown. Well, I mean, one of those three.
Well, absolutely. But
5 minutes to go here in the third quarter, and we're starting to see these Rochester backs running downhill.
And
back in Hadashell.
That was back-to-back great blocks by Harper and Adams on that right side, though, too.
Again, straight T backfield, two tight ends for Rochester from the Northfield 42. Hunting hands off to Hadashell. Hadashell again, left side, dragging some Northfield tacklers inside the 35-yard line to the 34, and we're going to have an extra curricular flag for a late hit. As Hadashell gets to the 34-yard line, and that's going to probably attack on a couple of extra yards for the Rochester Zebras.
Hadashell picking up 9.5 yards by himself and add another 15 for the unsportsmanlike penalty.
So that'll carry the ball inside the Northfield 25-yard line and inside the 20 and to the 19. So the Zebras will have the football after a great run by Hadashell, and then a 15-yard penalty against Northfield takes the ball to the North 19-yard line. First and 10 with 4:45 to play in the third. Rochester leading 12 to nothing. Shane is tight right. Bennett tight left. Straight T backfield for Rochester. Hunting under center with 20 on the play clock. Takes the snap. Gives to Heckathorn going left. Heckathorn tiptoeing his way through traffic. Still on his feet. Carrying the ball close to the 10. Yep. Pushing his way. And actually he's going to be shy to the 10. Giving the 11 and 8 yards. Well, it'll be second and two.
Well, you can almost guess that that T backfield is going to be the play call until they score.
Yeah.
Why not, though, if they're getting these 7, 8, 9 yard, 10 per carry?
I'm sorry, give him the 12, Brad. It'll be a pickup of 7. It'll be second and 3. Ball at the 12-yard line, 4:13 to play in the third quarter. It'll be Hadashell, Beck, and Heckathorn left to right in the backfield. Two tight ends for the Zebras on second down and 3. Hadashell right side. Hadashell dodges one tackler, carries the ball inside the 10 to about the 9.
It's gonna be a little short. Yeah.
Shy of a first down, it'll be third and 1. 3:50 to play in the third quarter. Rochester has it at the 10. Third down and 1, ball at the 10-yard line for Rochester. Shane brings the play in from the line of scrimmage. Ball in the middle of the field, Rochester going to our left. Rochester breaks the huddle. They'll send Heckathorn wide to the right side. Bennett split left. High backs for the Zebras. Shane is tight right. From the 10-yard line, third and 1. Hunting with 10 on the play clock gives to Beck. West Beck looking for the end zone. And is cut down at the 6. Great individual effort by Northfield. So I thought he had a...
Yeah, just about the time you think Beck's going to break loose and run away from people. He just doesn't have that next gear. I don't know. Maybe he does and we just never see it. But... Boy, every time you think he's got a little daylight and you're waiting for that next gear to come, somebody drags him down.
Give him 4. It'll be first and goal at the 6. Ball in the near hash. The Zebras go back to that straight T look. Two tight ends. Bennett left. Kistler right. Hunting under center on first and goal from the 6. Hadashell right side. Hadashell lowers his head. Gets to the 2. Pick up a 4. It'll be second and down. Second and goal from the 2-yard line for the Rochester Zebras.
And now the Rochester Zebras in this wing T formation for the last 30 or 40 yards, looking like the team that we expect to see. You 6-7 yards every carry, give it to 3 different backs, and the offensive line, everybody's not only making their block, but they're holding their block long enough for the backs to get through the hole.
Second a goal from the 2 for the Zebras. Everybody in tight again. Straight T backfield. Hadashell now goes in motion to the right side. Hunting takes a snap. Beck goes right into the end zone. Touchdown, Zebras. Wes Beck scores from 2 yards out.
Just your run-of-the-mill dive play. Hadashell leading the hole. Beck right behind him. Great job on that right side of the Rochester offensive line, and they get the 2 yards they need to tack on another 6 points.
That was a much better effort by the all 5 offensive linemen for the Zebras with Schaefer, Music, Basham, Harper, and Adams.
Zebras will go for 2 again, and they'll stay with that same formation look. 2 tight ends, Bennett left, Shane right, straight T backfield. Heckathorn goes left, looking for the end zone. 2-point conversion is good. 2:23 to play in the third. It's 20 to nothing, Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 2:23 to play in the third quarter. Wes Beck finds the end zone.
9 plays, 60 yards, like you said, capped off by a Wes Beck 2-yard touchdown run. The 2-point conversion was good. Zebras lead 20-0 with 2.5 to play in the third quarter.
And Wilson Lee will come on to kick off for the Zebras. Short kick tonight for Wilson. In the pregame, we were watching him.
He hit a 40.
He was close to 35 or 40. You're right. It's all that excellent coaching he's getting on the side. You know him.
Kevin?
So here we go. Wilson Lee, high end over end kick, short kick. Viger takes it inside the 25, follows his blockers left side. Viger cuts it back inside of the 40. Still on his feet at midfield. Oh, it's out of the ball.
Out of bounds.
And I think it goes out of bounds. Wow. But it goes out of bounds inside the 50. Looks like maybe at the Rochester 46. Where are they going to mark this for sure? What a fantastic return by Viger for Northfield.
It was a great return. He might have even gained another 3 or 4 yards on the fumble. But, yeah, another good job. Northfield return that time. You know, he's able to catch the football.
So they're going to give the Northfield the football at the 48-yard line of the Zebras. And it'll be first and 10 for Northfield. And the Norse on the football. 2:12 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 20-0. Frieden under center. Bickle, your fullback, behind him. Short comes in motion to the near side. Quick hitter to Viger. Viger's got the catch, and it looks like he's close to another Northfield first down.
That was the big play that went for 44 yards there in the first quarter. This time the Rochester Zebras do a little better job of defending it.
It's a little play action, toss up to your tight end maybe for 3 or 4 yards, and then
give him 9 on the pitch and catch. It'll be second and 1 inside the Rochester 40 at the 39-yard line, the 1:45 to play in the third. Again, Rochester up 20-0. Northfield quickly on the football. Frieden looks up and down the line, sets a club with 15 on the play clock. Short comes in motion to the near side. Gives to Viger on the end around. Viger on the counter, has a first down. Pushes his way to the Rochester 35. He's going to get four on the carry and another Northfield first down with 1:30 to play in the third. Clock rolls here at Northfield, ball on the far hash.
Northfield trying to mix things up here with a quick slant pass and then the counter coming back with Viger. They're trying to catch Rochester sleeping on the backside or not being, you know, just not being ready.
I don't think that we've seen that more than 2 times from either the quick hitter or the
You're right. Well, the other thing is we haven't seen 2 plays in a row that didn't involve Bickle.
Yeah. Short in motion to the near side. Short gets the pitch coming to the near side. He's got some blockers. Tries to get to the 35, back to the line of scrimmage. He might have done that. Nice job by Bennett on this far near side, and Abbott cutting down after a gain of nothing.
I'll tell you what, that's 3 plays in a row, and we have not seen Bickle.
Yeah. So it'll be second down and 10 at the Rochester 35-yard line, 50 seconds to play. In the third quarter, again, Rochester leads 20-0.
Now you're looking at second and 10.
You'll see Bickle this
You'll
time.
See Bickle.
That's what
I was thinking.
They'll send 2 receivers wide to the left. Will Northfield ball on the near side. So that's the wide side of the field. 13 on the play clock. Frieden sets a line. Viger goes in motion left on the option. Zebras stack up Frieden and
Bickle
for no gain. It'll be third and 10 with 22 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Well, again, Bickle had the football that time, and Frieden not wanting to pull it out, and so the Rochester doing a great job of just taking them both out.
I was going to say, it's hard to get a gain and 2 guys winning the ball at the same time.
10 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 20-0, and Northfield just going to let the quarter come to an end. After 3, the Zebras lead 20-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
Meet Bob and Stan. Both bought new TVs. Stan watches all the popular ringside live events, boxing, wrestling, and the big fight. Bob can't. Stan gets out-of-market sports packages of baseball, hockey, and basketball. Bob can't. Stan gets live concerts and the hottest Hollywood hits. What's the difference? Stan uses in-demand's pay-per-view for all the special events, sports programs, and the newest movie releases. So call RTC today and start your own pay-per-view experience.
Quarter with 8 minutes to go, and then John Glenn leads.
8 minutes to go in the third?
Did I say that right? Yeah, in the third quarter.
It's 22-14.
John Glenn 18-0 over LaVille, and then Winamac 26-6 over South Newton.
Okay. And it's 20-0 here, Rochester leading Northfield as we go to the fourth and final quarter here at Northfield High School. And Northfield with the third down and 10 at the Rochester 35. Frieden under center. Beyer comes in motion to the near side. There's a quick hitter in the flat. It is
underthrown and no good.
Well, was it incomplete? I thought I saw him wave it off. It looks like it is complete. Give him a yard. It'll be fourth and nine. After a one-yard pass play.
Trying to set up a screen out there on the right side, and he just threw it almost into the ground. Yeah. The receiver had to go down to the ground to catch it.
Wide open.
Yeah.
And Northfield will go for it. Fourth and nine at the Rochester 34. 11.5 to play in the football game. Rochester up 20-0. Frieden directs traffic. Now turns around and says something to Bickle. Now up under center again and sets a line with eight on the play clock. On the option, Bickle takes a handoff and is stopped short. Rochester going to take over on downs at their own 32-yard line. Rochester doing a great job up front right now, taking away that first option, which has been Bickle, and I guess not right now, the entire night. They've been doing a great job.
Bickle only 47 yards on 15 carries, and this is somebody that had 460 yards in three games.
Yep.
So leading the TRC right now, and Rochester doing a great job of shutting him down.
Well, not only are they taking away Bickle, but it looks like at the same time taking away Frieden, so he can't run to the outside.
And Bickle's biggest run all night has been 7 yards.
Yeah. So Rochester will start on this drive at their own 32 with two tight ends and a straight T backfield. Hattishell gets the carry going right from Hunting, and not a lot there. Northfield stacks him up for virtually nothing. It'll be second and long for the Rochester Zebras. Give him a yard, it'll be second and nine. Under 11 to play in the game, 20-0 Rochester. They've got a second down and nine at their own 33-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field, the Zebras going to our right.
Hattishell, on the other hand, 21 carries, 87 yards and a touchdown.
And those 87 yards haven't been easy.
No, he's had a couple of big runs of 15 and 20 yards. He had a 20-yard run called back, but most of them have been in the 7 to 8 to 5 yard range.
Back to pass, Kissler, the intended receiver. Great job by Short, knocking it down. Kissler was behind the defense, Short defensively made a great play that probably would have saved a great big gain.
Yeah,
and that'll bring up third and nine. So Rochester lined up in the same formation, the two tight ends and straight T backfield. Hunting threw out of that formation. Had Kissler behind the defense, but underthrew him, and that'll bring up third and nine.
That was a good job defensively by Northfield. You know, if he doesn't make that play, like you said, that's a 25-30-yard gain.
So now third down and nine for the Zebras. Two wideouts, one to each side. I-backs for Hunting with 10 on the play clock. John back to pass on the screen. Flips it to the far side to Hattishell. Through his hands, incomplete, fourth and nine.
Well, Hunting had to get rid of that in a hurry. You know, the linemen are coached to let those players, the defenders, come through on the screen, and boy, Northfield showing their speed on that defensive line. If they're getting back quick enough, that Hunting doesn't have time to make a good throw to Hattishell.
And if Hattishell catches that, he loses yards.
Yeah, there's the defense out there on the corner on Hattishell was good too.
Fourth down and nine for the Zebras. Wes Beck back to punt. He stands at about his 20. Short and Viger back inside their 40 to receive the kick with 10:24 to play in the game. Beck gets it away. A sideways kick taken inside the 25. And then Schaefer again.
Jeez, Jordan
drops Viger for basically no gain.
Well, and Jordan Schaefer's got a man trying for 10 yards to block him, and Jordan Schaefer doesn't even slow down. He just keeps right on plowing towards the receiver and brings him down.
First and 10 for Northfield at the 36-yard line, their own 36, going to our left with 10:16 to play in the game. Rochester leading 20-0. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Wide to the near side for Northfield is Brown. Kendall split right.
Well, we've seen Northfield try and mix it up a little bit with some little more complicated offensive plays and getting away from Bickle.
Short goes in motion to the far side. Here, back to pass. Here's a screen. Complete to Short. Short then is dropped by Heckathorn. behind there or inside the 35, back to the 33. He's going to lose 3 yards, and it'll be second down and 13. Nice job by Schaefer and Heckathorn bringing Bickle down after he caught the pass.
After that punt, Wes Beck, actually, he limped off a little bit to the sideline. He's over there talking to Christina. Austin Hoover took his spot at defensive end, and then Tanner Music moved to the nose tackle.
Okay. Second down and 13 for Northfield, back at their own 33 with 9:40 to play in the game. Frieden with 15 on the play clock, sets a line. Back to pass, looks right, throws right, the quick hitter. Oh, what a fantastic catch by Short. One-handed catch takes the ball out to the 44-yard line.
In full stride.
Yeah, what a fantastic catch. So he's going to pick up about 10 yards. It'll bring up third down and 3 with 9:15 to play in the football game. Ball at the Northfield 44. Frieden brings the club quickly to the line. On the ball now. Sets the line on third and 3. Back to pass. Frieden rolls out of the pocket, comes to the near side, being chased in the backside, and he fumbles the football out of bounds. Great job by Hadashell, never giving up on that play, and almost knocked the football out of bounds, back at the 40.
Had they had a few more yards, they might have been able to come up with a fumble on that, right at the sideline, though, and Hadashell knocking the ball out of his hands.
Yeah, when you're scuffling like that, like Frieden was doing there, and Hadashell's running full steam, you're not going to get away from it.
Yeah. Fourth and 6 for Northfield after the 4-yard loss. With 8:56 to play in the game, with Zebras leading 20-0. Northfield will go for it on 4th and 6 at their own 40. Frieden, quickly, under center, back to pass. Here comes some pressure in the middle of the field, incomplete, and Rochester will take over on downs. That was intended for Short again on the same pass play where Short just caught it one-handed.
Yeah, great that job. Time, I was going to say, great job by Hadashell on the defense that time. Again, that slant, quick slant pattern pass that they've had success with tonight. This time Hadashell shoulder to shoulder was shorter. He's unable to drag it in.
Good news, at least Wes Beck's back at the fullback position. That limping just must have been precautionary.
First and 10 for the Zebras at the Northfield 40. Ball in the near hash. Heckathorn split left. Bennett split right. Short side of the field. I-backs for the Zebras. Hadashell right up the middle. Jacob Hadashell inside the 30, down to the 25, inside the 25 to about the 23.
17 yards on that carry for Hadashell.
Puts him over 100.
That'll do it.
Yes, it does, 104.
First and 10 for the Zebras at the Northfield 23-yard line with 8:46 to play in the game. They'll line up in that same formation. They'll send Heckathorn wide left. Bennett wide right. Heckathorn dots the I with Kistler tight left. Hunting under center with 18 on the play clock. Plenty of time. Where's the fire, fellas? Snap again to Hadashell. Hadashell, not as big a gain this time. Give him 3 as he gets it to the 20. It'll be 2nd and 7 with 8:25 to play in the game. I've got to assume the play coming in from the sideline is telling John Hunting, hey, we can look at the play clock. We don't have to snap that at 18.
Yeah.
Last couple of plays, Hadashell running to Schaefer and Music's side of the offensive line, and those two young gentlemen doing a great job of opening up some holes for Hadashell. He's getting into that second level of the Norse defense before he gets tackled.
2nd and 7, 10 on the play clock. Tunting takes the snap, gives to Hadashell again, and he is met by a wall of blue back at the 23, so he's going to lose the 3 he just got. It'll be 3rd and 10. Northfield won the war there. Pushes him back 3 yards, 7.5 to play in the game. It's 3rd down and 10 for the Zebras at the Northfield 23-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field. Again, Rochester going to our right. Bennett goes split left. Heckathorn split right. Split backs for Hunting with Kistler tied to the right. 12 on the play clock. Back to pass. Looking for Bennett in the end zone. Bennett through his hands and out of bounds. It'll be 4th down and 10. Good coverage on that far side by Frieden for Northfield.
Yeah, it was. I think if the ball's thrown in front of Bennett, he has a better opportunity to try and catch it. That ball's kind of thrown behind him, and he had to turn around. He turned his whole body in the process of running downfield to try and catch it over the defense.
4th and 10 for the Zebras at the Northfield 23-yard line. 7:15 to play in the game. Bennett split left. Heckathorn wide to the right side. Your tight end to the right now is Shane. Shotgun formation for Hunting. John on 4th and 10 takes the snap. High snap on the draw, gives to Hattischel. Hattischel, maybe
nothing.
Get back to the line of scrimmage. Northfield not fooled, and they will take over on downs. 7-12 to play in the game. Rochester up 20-0, and the Zebras give the football back to Northfield inside their 25-yard line. Frieden now comes out of the football game. The Drake Richter now the quarterback for Northfield. Three receivers, two to the right, one to the left. Back to pass is Northfield. Flips it out to the far side. It is complete. And I believe that was to Kendall. We'll wait and see who, or was that? Yeah, it was Kendall as he takes it out to the 29-yard line. Give him six on the play. It'll be second down and about four. That kid's got a good arm. Drake Richter, 5'8 junior.
Maybe why he's in the game.
Yeah. Richter brings a club to the line of scrimmage. One receiver to the right, two to the near side. Richter under center, the junior on second and four. Richter, back to pass. Here comes some pressure from the backside. Flows it to the sideline. It is incomplete. John Hunting, the closest one there. That was intended, though, for Viger. It'll bring up third down and a four.
Talk about the good arm. He overthrew everybody by about 6 yards on a running across his body pass.
6.5 minutes to play in the game. Rochester up 20-0. Northfield looking at third down and four at their own 29-yard line.
This could be the last series for the starting defense for the Zebras if they shut them out.
I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. Third and four for Northfield at their own 39. Richter under center. Back to pass. Looks to the near side. On the slant, it is incomplete. Intended for Brown on the slant. It'll bring up fourth down and four.
You know, it looks like he just needs a little bit more, just needs to calm down just a little bit. He looks like he's a little bit jacked up being in the ball game right now.
Can't hardly blame him.
He did a great job on that play, though. I'll give him credit for that. He looked at the receiver short and then threw the ball long, just threw it a little bit too far out in front of the receiver.
Fourth and four, three receivers for Northfield, two to the near, one to the far. Richter, back to pass. Here comes some pressure. He's hit, but he gets it off to Viger, and Viger gets it across the 35 to the 36, and that's a Northfield first down. Give him seven on the pitch and catch. Yeah, six on the pitch and catch. But as Richter gets drilled, he gets the ball away to Viger for a first down. 6.5 to play in the football game. Again, Rochester up 20-0. Viger comes wide to the near side. Brown and Kendall split right. Richter under center with Bickle behind him. Richter back to pass. Two-step drop. Gets it out to Kendall. He slips a tackle. Kendall's still on his feet. Carries the Zebras inside the 50. Inside to Rochester territory. Give him the 48. It'll be another first down for Northfield. That's about a two-step drop. And he gets rid of the ball to Richter quickly.
Yeah, he does. And this time Kendall does a good job of slipping that first tackle attempt and picking up the 16 yards in the first down. Rochester trying to tackle by the football.
Yeah.
And in the meantime, Kendall just keeps, you know, pushing his way downfield.
First and 10 for Northfield at the Rochester 48-yard line. Richter quickly on the ball. Clock rolls, 6 minutes to play in the game. Richter back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Slips, gets away from McLaughlin. He keeps it, goes to the Rochester sideline and out of bounds.
Well, it's looks like he's got a little bit of speed, too.
I think he needed it there.
He tried to outrun Hattischel, yeah.
Northfield has ran six plays this series, all of them with Richter under center.
Yep.
Five out of the six have been passes, and that one is supposed to be a pass. So it's safe to say when number 12 is in the game, the ball is going to be in the air.
Two-yard pickup for Richter. It'll be second and eight. 5:55 to play in the game. Three receivers, two to the near side, one to the far. And the flanker to the slot man is short to the near side. Richter under center, back to pass. Rolls away from pressure, looking down on the near side. Schaefer has him. He just throws it out of bounds. What a great headsy play by a junior. And Schaefer had him, dragging him down for a sack, and he just throws it to the sideline and out of bounds. What a fantastic heads-up play.
That was a good play by Richter. Like you say, he had Hattischel pursuing him from the from the left side, and Schaefer coming from the tackle position gets a hold of his jersey, and they're going to call.
Is that any intentional grounding?
I don't know what they're going to call.
Is there not a tackle box in high school?
That's what they're calling.
There it is.
It's going to be intentional grounding on Northfield.
Wow, he was way outside.
So I think that he was back now. Where was he when he threw the football is the question. Are they going to say he... So they're going to mark it off from the 50. It's going to push Northfield back to their own 45-yard line.
Yeah, I don't agree with that call.
So he's going to lose 7 yards. He's going to lose seven yards.
Because he's being tackled by Schaefer from behind. I mean, Schaefer's got a hold of the back of his jersey, pulling him down, and he's, you know, winging the ball downfield, and it goes, you know,
I'm not quite,
30
I don't quite
yards in the air
that.
Out of bounds.
Yeah,
I don't get it.
So it'll be third down and 17 for Northfield back at their 45-yard line with 5:48 to play in the football game with Richter under center. Four receivers. Richter back to pass. And his pass is blocked away by Hadashell. Hadashell in his mug. And it'll be fourth down and 17. Hadashell probably just should have taken that off his hand if he was going to.
He almost did, yeah. Hadashell jumping up in the air, but I think the ball hit him in the stomach. So
fourth and 17 for Northfield at their own 45, and they will go for it. 5:44 to play in the game. Again, Rochester up 20-0. 6-0 at halftime. And then Rochester scores twice in the third quarter and adds a two-point conversion, and that's how we got to 20. So fourth and 17 for the Norse. Richter under center. Takes a snap. 2-3-step drop. He throws a football. Rochester picks it up. Had a shell down the near sideline and then falls down. The turf monster got him at the 21.
He tripped over the 20-yard line.
And Richter is hurt. Had a shell come in on his blind side and hit Richter hard. The ball pops loose. Hadashell picks it up with open field in front of him, and the turf monster jumps up and grabs him at the 21-yard line. So that's where Rochester will take over here.
Just could not keep his balance in the open field.
Wow. So it'll be first and 10 for Rochester at the Northfield 21-yard line with 5.5 to play in the football game. The Zebras up 20-0. You think that somebody might talk to Jacob Hadashell about that return there?
Yeah. I think he might get a little bit of ribbing about that.
That's right. Yeah, you probably could.
I could teach him.
Make that Abbott split left. Bennett wide right. Hadashell takes the ball left. Lowers his head, still driving his feet, still on his feet, and dives ahead to about the 11-yard line. He's going to be close to a Zebra first down. Yeah, maybe you want to teach him how to scoop and go.
It's not that difficult.
Yeah, well, apparently. I mean, living proof right here, it's not that difficult.
I mean, I'm not trying to talk about it or anything, but.
It's going to be close enough to measure. So it'll be either second and inches or first and 10. Either way, Rochester has it at the Northfield 11-yard line with 5:23 to play in the football game.
I have the video on my iPad. I'll send it to him.
You're kidding.
Why would I be kidding? It's my only touchdown ever.
On your iPad?
Absolutely. Yeah. You know what? I'm posting it on Facebook tomorrow for you.
Will you?
I'll tag you both.
Wait till throwback Thursday.
Throwback Saturday. Is there one?
Sure.
I want it up soon.
So it'll be, what was that? That was a quick measurement. Good heavens.
So they're going to call it a first down.
Yeah, first down.
Exactly. 10 yards.
First and 10 from the 11-yard line now for Rochester. As Bennett goes split left. Abbott wide right. Beck. And now Wilson Lee split in the backfield. From the 11-yard line, Hunting gives to Beck. Beck right side gets to the 10. Great solo tackle there by Northfield.
I have an interesting TRC
interesting.
Score tonight.
All right.
We have Southwood 32, Valley 23.
Is that a final?
No, not a final.
Okay. So it'll be second and 9 after a 1-yard pickup for Wes Beck. The ball at the 10-yard line with 4:45 to play in the game. Again, Rochester leading 20-0 here at Northfield High School. Zebras will have two tight ends. Shane to the right, Bennett to the left, straight tee backfield. Lee, Beck, and Abbott left to right. Here's a snap. Brett Abbott takes it going left, cuts it back inside, spins his way, getting inside the 5-yard line, down to around the 4. Pickup of about 5 yards, and it'll be 3rd down and 3. 3rd and 3, ball at the 4-yard line of Northfield. And Abbott did a pretty good job there running the football.
Yeah, he did.
Rochester taking a lot of time off the play clock here as it's under 20 seconds. Still in the huddle are the Zebras.
And the game clock running as well. So,
right. Under 4 to play in the game. 10 down the play clock. Straight tee backfield for the Zebras. Two tight ends. Hunting under center from the 4-yard line. John takes a snap. Gives a Lee, right side, off the right side of the line, looking
Wilson
for the end zone, still driving his legs, still looking for the end zone. Touchdown, Zebras.
Nice drive by Wilson Lee. 6-yard.
Do we have a flag on the play? Flag on the play.
Yeah, it's going to come back.
And we're going to have a hold against the Zebras, so Wilson Lee does not get into the end zone.
Nah, that's too bad.
That
was a great
run.
That was a great run by Wilson Lee, a great individual effort for 6 yards. You know, he just pushed and drove and pushed and drove. Unfortunately.
Yeah, he was hit at the line of scrimmage. Individual effort got him in there.
He took 4 Norsemen with him into the end zone.
So it'll back him up 10. 3rd down at about 13 now. The ball is spotted back at the 14-yard line.
And you know the Zebras don't want to pass.
Nah.
So we'll look to see if that three-headed monster of the Triple T can continue to work.
3rd and 13 for the Zebras. Bennett split left, Abbott split right.
And they're going to run it.
Wilson Lee dots the I. Shane is tight left. Back to passes. Hunting in the middle of the field to Bennett. Bennett's got the catch and a touchdown.
So what do we know? That's why we're in the press box.
Yeah, right.
I said pass in my head.
Hunting's, 14-yard pass
yep.
play to Bennett for the touchdown.
With 3:20 to play in the football game, Rochester now up 26-0. And it looks like Wilson Lee will attempt the extra point.
Five plays,
21
yards
instead
of a turnover.
26-0, Wilson Lee to attempt the extra point. Last time he was on the field, he got it blocked. Abbott is the holder. Snap is back, hold is down, here comes the pressure, and it's blocked again. However, I don't think that one got very high off the ground.
No, I don't think so either. I don't know that Abbott ever got a good, clean set on the putting the ball down.
26-0 Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. 3 minutes, 20 seconds to play in the game. The Rochester Zebras score on a pass play.
5 plays, 21 yards, 13-yard pass play from Hunting to Bennett. PAT by Wilson Lee was no good or blocked. Zebras lead 26-0 with 3:20 remaining in the fourth. A TRC update real quick. We have North Miami over Wabash 31-28.
Win.
No idea where the time and
all right. Well,
quarter
close.
Is.
Third
quarter.
They're doing nothing but passing.
31-28. Could very well
that
be.
Much, maybe.
Wilson lead a kick. End over end kick. Picked up by Short before the 25. Short of the 25. Brings all the way across the field and dropped from behind at the 26-yard line. And that's where Northfield will start here.
Connor McLaughlin for the Zebras on the tackle.
I don't want to speak too early because there still is 3 minutes left in the game, but Zebras are coming off a 14-0 victory over Wabash. They're up 26-0 right now. There's nothing better than back-to-back conference shutouts.
Well, we still got a ways to go there.
Yeah, with 3 minutes remaining.
And Frieden back on the field. You got to wonder how Richter is feeling. I don't see him on the sideline.
Number
he took
for the Zebras.
Pretty good shot
there.
From Adeshell on the last series.
So Frieden under center from his own 27-yard line. Rochester up 26-0. Frieden on the option. Gives to the fullback. Nope, that's not Bickle.
Younger brother, Frieden.
Yeah. Jensen Frieden, the 5'8 sophomore, gets the carry right up the middle and gets it out to the 41-yard line. A pickup of 14 yards and a Northfield first down.
Another first and 10.
Carter Frieden brings the club to the line of scrimmage. Jensen Frayden behind him. On first and 10 for Northfield, under 3 to play in the game. Herter Frieden on the option, gives to Jensen Frieden, and he is stacked up for nothing. Not very much there for the sophomore running back. It'll be second and long for Northfield with 2:40 to play in the football game. Again, Rochester leading 26 to nothing.
And the conference's leading rusher, Josh Bickle. We haven't seen much of him in this second half. He's got 47 yards.
You're right.
For the entire ball game.
I'm not sure he had much more than that at halftime, did he?
No.
Yeah. Second and 9 for Northfield at their own 42.
But that kind of changes your game plan when you're down 20.
Yeah, you're right. Frieden back to pass, rolls to the right, throws it down the far side. It's complete, wide open and short. Short down the far sideline, inside the 30, inside the 20, down around the 15-yard line, first and 10 for Northfield.
Zebras have brought in about half of the new players on defense. One number I see is Ross Pearson, 31. Three other guys, they're not on our roster, so.
I beg your pardon, that got to the 22. Must have stepped out of bounds for the 22. But give him 20 on the pickup. It'll be first and 10 for Northfield at the Rochester 22-yard line.
Randall Brock enters the game. Yeah, Thomas Rensberger enters the game.
I was going to say, I think we got some new kids out there we probably need to get
things out. Jordan Short?
Short, that's correct. First and 10, Northfield, after a 20-yard pitch and catch from Frieden to Short.
Daniel Butler also enters the game.
Okay. Frieden under center with 2 minutes to play in the game. Takes a snap. Give to Jensen Frieden. And second effort gets him inside the 20 to the 19. Give him 3. It'll be second and 7. Rochester up 26 to nothing. And Rochester will move to 3-1 overall, 2-0 in the TRC. Northfield will drop their first one of the year and move their record to 3-1 overall and 1-1 in the Three Rivers Conference. For home next week with Southwood, it's homecoming 2014.
Oh, I know how the coaching staff loves that.
Loves homecoming week. 90 seconds to play in the game. 10 on the play clock. Frieden looks back, talks to Jensen Frieden. Now Carter under center with 4 on the play clock. Takes a snap, back to pass, looks left, throws left. It is incomplete. Had him on the slant. And Rensberger on the coverage. It'll be second down and 7. Boy, had him too.
Yeah, he did.
If Brown catches that, he's in the end zone untouched.
Yep, had the inside position on the cornerback and just overthrew him.
Yep.
Last Southwood Valley update, it was 32-23. There's been 2 touchdowns since, both of them to Southwood, 44-23.
Holy cow.
That's scoring quickly. A minute 18 to play in this one.
That's who Rochester gets next week. Southwood.
Yeah. And on homecoming.
Sounds like they've got an offensive weapon down there as well.
Frieden under center on 3rd and 7. Back to pass. Here comes some pressure. Frieden is sacked by McLaughlin.
Yep, nice job by McLaughlin.
And back at the 26. Going to lose 7. 4th down and 14 for Northfield with 60 seconds play in the game. Rochester up 26 to nothing. We're under a minute to play in the football game. Northfield obviously will be going for it. It's on their 26-yard line going to our left. Frieden brings the club to the line of scrimmage with 45 seconds to play in the game. Frieden on 4th and 14. Back to pass. Looks right. Throws to the right. It is complete. But did he get to the marker?
It's really close.
That's going to be really close. I'm not sure. I don't think he got to the marker.
I think he caught it and just dropped. Nope. Here comes the offense for the Zebras.
Give him 13. Give him 13 on the pitch and catch. It'll be first down for Rochester, so they'll line up in the victory formation.
Who was the receiver on that?
Short.
Okay, thank you.
I thought I might have spoke too soon on that goose egg,
yeah,
but
I
hey,
did too.
There it is. Well, yeah, there it is.
First and 10 for the Zebras. At the 13-yard line with 35 seconds to play in the game, and Hunting will take the snap and take an E. Might need 1, might need 2, but definitely going to take this first one. Hunting under center, takes the knee, and the clock rolls. And that's going to do it.
That should do it.
The Rochester Zebras have knocked off the Northfield Norsemen here at Northfield High School by the final of 26 to nothing. You're listening to Zebra Football 92.1 WROI.
RTC Communications, your local.
49. 60. 65.